go in the world. They're really decent, good people who love their children, care about things. You know, and I think my perspective will be altered when I come back. I won't be so wildly enthusiastic about Halloween, having seen children.
It's because Iraqi nurses are having a difficult time getting to work due to high transportation costs and dangerous roadways.
Is your family happy about you going?
No, but they're supportive.
Beck says while she is a little nervous about her journey, she's convinced her hard work will not go unnoticed. Leonard Horton, Channel 6 Eyewitness News, Tallahassee.
Beck was once a nurse in the Capital Regional Medical Center's orthopedic unit. Former Democratic gubernatorial candidate Bill McBride is home from the hospital after collapsing at a health club last week. 58-year-old McBride, who lost the governor's race in November to Governor Jeb Bush, was released from Tampa General Hospital last night. He underwent an angioplasty to open closed coronary arteries that caused him to collapse Thursday while he was working out at Harbor Island Athletic Club. Some local bikers came out today to support an important cause. More than 400 bikers joined the Chrome Divas for the second annual Breast Cancer Poker Run. The bikers hope to reach their goal of $20,000, which will benefit the Women's Pavilion at TMH. Organizers say we should all care about breast cancer.
Anybody knows someone with breast cancer, whether it's a family member, a friend. It just affects everybody, I think, and not only women.
Some of the money raised will go towards buying hats for women undergoing chemotherapy. Consumers apparently don't focus on price as much as they used to when deciding where to do most of their shopping. A recent study suggests many shoppers are choosing a favorite store based on other factors, such as customer service. University of Florida researchers say competition among retailers has made price less important to consumers than in the past, since competitors often match discounts. Research shows that a consumer's personal preference for shopping at one store has become the biggest factor in how much money they actually spend in one place.
Since retailers compete and have these weekly specials and so on, that would kind of drive consumers towards shopping around more just to take advantage of these competitive offers.
Surprisingly, research shows loyalty cards such as frequent shopper cards or membership discounts offer mixed results in attracting loyal customers. Today marks the first day of National Fire Prevention Week, and fire and rescue officials in the Rose City are doing their part in urging residents to take full observance. The Thomasville Fire Department will be in the community every day this week getting the word out about fire safety. They say maintaining smoke detectors are very important and can save lives. Fire officials recommend you check your detector at least once a month.
In the U.S., two-thirds of the house fires reported.
Less than three smoke detectors, one over each door in the house, especially the kitchen. You are watching the area's number one source for news. Still to come this Sunday evening, a shooting at a house of worship ends the life of three people. Plus, wait until you see what police discovered inside a New York City apartment complex. But first, let's turn things over to Matt Barentine down in the Weather Center. Matt, how are things looking for the work week?
Well, all I have to say first off is I'm sorry. I'm sorry this gorgeous weekend is all over, folks, and we're going to have to look towards the work week. Let's go ahead and check out some of our temperatures outside right now at our pinpoint stations. Looking pretty nice. Temperatures in the 60s, dew points in the 60s as well. We're talking about a forecast coming up that's going to include some slight changes. And, of course, we'll take a look at the tropics. All that coming up in just a few minutes.
Thanks to Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Florida, people had new reasons to smile today. One teacher found a new way to unwind. A grandfather paused to listen to the music. And an artist was reborn. Because on this day, our Blue Compliments program offered new choices, new alternatives, new reasons to smile. Which is why we're here. Blue Compliments, just one of many programs for many needs. From Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Florida.
He was having difficulties, and they told me.
Best source for news, weather, and sports to start your day. Art Myers, Jamie Prechter, and Rob Nucatola are people with coverage you can count on. Plus,
The stone crab season is just around the corner.
Please stay tuned to find out how that will help Tallahassee's Ronald McDonald House.
We'll see you in the next In the Spotlight.
Watch The Good Morning Show weekdays at 6, only on WCTV.
Welcome back, everyone. A Texas man who fought the driver of a moving truck died last night when the truck hit a tree. We begin our look at national news in Tampa, Florida. 20-year-old Hector Lopez of Houston was killed when the truck he was hanging from hit a tree in Tampa and landed on top of him. 21-year-old Carlos Jimenez of Tampa is under arrest and charged with DUI manslaughter and leaving the scene of an accident. The victim chased Jimenez for miles, bumping him three times and then blocking the way with his truck. It was not clear why the men were fighting, but they were acquaintances and had dated the same woman. A shooting Sunday morning at an Atlanta church has left three people dead and its members in shock. The shootings took place at Turner Monumental AME Church on the city's east side. Police say Sheila Wilson opened fire before services started, killing her mother and the pastor before committing suicide. No one else was in the sanctuary. Worshippers who knew Wilson say she was disturbed. Homeland Security Secretary Tom Ridge joined hundreds of observers Sunday to honor the memories of firefighters who have died in the line of duty in the past year. The National Fallen Firefighters Foundation's annual memorial is held every year on the campus of the National Fire Academy in Maryland. Along with remembering five Oregon firefighters who died in a van crash, the memorial honored nearly 100 other fallen firefighters. Local police and animal control officers in New York removed a nearly 500-pound tiger and a 5-foot alligator from a Manhattan apartment Saturday after callers tipped off officials. The animal's owner was taken into police custody Saturday night at a Philadelphia hospital where he was being treated for bite wounds from the cat. The tiger and alligator are now at an Ohio wildlife preserve. You are watching the area's number one source for news. Still to come, we'll find out what Mother Nature has in store for us this first week of October. Stay with us.
Pinpoint weather on WCTV. It's the latest conditions brought to you with pinpoint accuracy. Bright, sunny days or stormy afternoons. The Pinpoint Weather Team has the experience and the technology to bring you the weather information you need to know. Mike McCall, Rob Nucatola, and Matt Barentine, all with the seal of approval from the American Meteorological Society. All with the power of pinpoint technology behind them. For coverage you can count on, turn to Pinpoint Weather on WCTV. Brought to you by Payless Car Sales.
Hello, I'm Sheriff Larry Campbell. During the 42 years I've worked in law enforcement, I witnessed the good and the not so good in our society. One of the best things I've seen is the positive impact Cub Scouting and Boy Scouting has on our youth. Young people who grow up learning citizenship, developing personal responsibility and leadership, and building self-confidence become real assets to our community and our country. Scouting does all that and a whole lot more. I should know, my son's an Eagle Scout. To learn more about scouting, visit the new Scout office on Thomasville Road.
Each day, crimes are committed in our community, crimes that go unsolved. You never know where you are going to be or what you are going to see. Take a part in getting these crimes solved. Count on Eyewitness News and Crime Stoppers. Each Tuesday in Eyewitness News at 5:30 and 11, join Gary Barbot as he brings you the crime team's most wanted. If you have information about a crime, call Crime Stoppers at 891-HELP. Crime Stoppers doesn't want your name. They just want your information. Tuesdays on Eyewitness News at 5:30 and 11 on WCTV.
Hello, I'm the Georgia Brown Thrasher. Here's someone special who wants to talk with you.
Hello, I'm Faye Cook, a member of the Garden Club of Georgia, and I live in Ashburn. Trash and filth are being dumped on our roads everywhere.
You can help.
Don't litter, and ask others not to litter.
Georgia, keep it green and clean. A message from the Garden Club of Georgia and this member station of the Georgia Association of Broadcasters.
Doppler 6 Pinpoint Weather is brought to you by Payless Car Sales, Thomasville.
Welcome back, everyone. Matt is here with our weather. It has just been gorgeous outside. I am sad to see the weekend end because it's been so pretty.
Yeah, I know. A lot of folks probably thinking the same thing, getting ready to go to bed, head back to work in the morning. Yeah. Sorry, folks, but yeah, that's the way it works out. Valdosta 63 right now. Tallahassee sitting at 67 degrees, and the dew points are down there in the lower 60s, about where our temperature will end up this evening. Humidity is pretty good, and winds are calm. Pressure is steady. All that good stuff going on outside right now. A gorgeous end to a gorgeous weekend. Temperatures right now pretty much comfortable, sitting in the 60s, a couple degrees warmer than where we were at this point last night. But we have clear skies, and things are looking oh so nice once again for our Sunday evening. Some clouds to the north, some clouds to the south, but here we are in the middle, looking just fine and dandy. Let's go ahead and take on out talk about the tropics a little bit because still got some action there. And Hurricane Kate's first off at 33 north, 56.1 west. It has weakened during the day today to 90 mile per hour winds. And look at the movement off towards the north at 12 miles per hour. Now, Kate a little bit earlier today hit a wall. And that wall is a little frontal boundary right here. And Kate goes straight to the north once it hits it. Kate was moving off to the west, but now it's going towards the north, which will take it out to the Atlantic and not be a problem for anybody. Also, the other storm, talking about Larry. Now, Larry is no more. Larry has pushed down into Mexico and has fallen apart into a tropical depression, just dumping a lot of rain for the folks down there. So those two systems are gone. So is there anything else left in the tropics? Well, we do have some flare-ups out here over the Atlantic, but nothing is organizing at this point, so things look good out in the tropics for now. As far as what it looks like for us coming back home, talking about that dry air that's been in place, giving us this gorgeous weekend, gorgeous for the last few days, that dry air, you see it in this red here on the water vapor loop, is starting to erode, starting to get smaller. We have some moisture sliding in from the north. What does all that mean, Matt? Well, I'll talk about that right after this. The U.S. looking very good. You see a slight disturbance just off towards our north over the Mississippi Valley, heading on over towards Alabama and Georgia. That's a little frontal boundary that is just off towards the north, and it is headed towards us, but its frontal boundary is not very special. It has not much of a kick to it. So as it comes in late tomorrow, it's going to start to spread some extra clouds, increase the rain chances, just slightly, to about 20% Monday. Then as we look on towards Monday night on into Tuesday, we'll raise those rain chances to about 30 to 40%. So there will be a few scattered showers certainly possible, which would be good news because we have had no rain so far in October. And if we don't get any rain out of this, I don't see any more coming in the foreseeable future. So whatever we can squeeze out of this little system would be good. So we're going to keep our fingers crossed for that. And it looks like for our tomorrow, most of the day will be just partly cloudy and rather warm. And we'll have those clouds build and the chance of showers coming later in the day on to Monday evening and then on into Tuesday as well. Out on the water tomorrow, partly cloudy, a few of those isolated showers. Winds out of the southeast at only 5 to 10 knots, seas 1 to 2 feet in the smooth to light chop on those protected waters. Your Gulf tides, Apalachicola, Carabel, Seanatch, your St. Mark's River entrance. We'll be talking about low tides real early on tomorrow morning. Now, your forecast for the rest of the night, not bad at all. Just another cool night out there, mostly clear. Some patchy fog, temperature down to around 60. And as we look on for your Monday, going to be a few more clouds around what we've seen the past couple of days, and a few isolated showers certainly possible tomorrow during the day. We'll raise those rain chances by tomorrow night on into Tuesday to about 30 to 40%, so more of the scattered variety, high of 86 here for your Monday. And as you check out your next 5 days, all in all, not a bad forecast. We do see that chance of rain on Tuesday. Let's hope we do get some of that rain, like I said. At this point, we do kind of need it. And on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, things clear out pretty nicely once again. And I think we're setting ourselves up for a pretty nice weekend next weekend, and of course,
big-time
Miami game coming up, so I know all of that's going to be good.
What the heck are you talking about? The Hurricanes in town on Saturday.
Yeah.
It's a Hurricane. Okay. Football team. Mm-hmm. But you knew that.
We missed the weather pun, Bo. We're just, you know.
Wow. I'm on it tonight, aren't I? Bringing my A game tonight, kids. It's good times ahead. The Rattlers brought their A game on Saturday, taking on Jackson State up in Indy. We'll have a reflection on that and a whole day in NFL and a bunch of other stuff. Stick around. Sports is next.
Introducing Winn-Dixie's Real Dollar Deals. You'll find thousands of items, all for a buck. That's right. Every aisle. Every day. A dollar is all you pay. It's like having a dollar store in our store. Winn-Dixie, the real deal.
On behalf of the entire staff of the Tallahassee Democrat, I'd like to say thank you. Your trust in us has made us the fastest growing newspaper of our circulation size in all of
it. So, anything else?
Think being a big sister means you have to do hours and hours of arts and crafts projects? Think again.
Okay, let's do it again.
To learn more about becoming a big brother or big sister, call 1-888-412-BIGS.
The FAMU Rattlers are ready to strike, strike, and strike again. And you're invited to catch all of the highlights on the Billy Joe Show. I'm Keith Miles, along with FAMU head coach Billy Joe.
Rattler football is always exciting, and this year will be no exception for the orange and green. This season presents us with a lot of challenges. We'll be with you here every Sunday night after Eyewitness News on WCTV.
This week, FAMU takes on Jackson State in the Circle City Classic.
Hey there, folks. It is oh so good to see you. Well, this was the game that Florida A&M head coach Billy Joe had been waiting for the first time this season. Coach Joe's bunch just clicked. It sounds simple.
Get them.
That's right.
On Saturday, and it is going to be quite the game, I would think.
That's what I hear.
It will be. Yeah, maybe you could go ahead and watch it or something, April.
I might just do that.
All right, though. I hope you do.
All right, still to come, we'll tell you about an international event geared to get kids off on the right foot. Stay with us.
Am I dreaming, or is every woman here wearing an incredible dress?
Well, it is Dress Week at Ross.
Dress Week at Ross. Don't miss it.
Mothers in Crisis, this is Miss Tompkins. How may we help you? I do a little bit of everything around here. Yes, we do have a Men in Crisis chapter. They meet every Thursday night from 7 to 9 p.m. Sure, let me take down your information. No, thank you. And remember, as long as there's breath in your body, there's hope.
For more information about Men in Crisis, contact Mothers in Crisis. The number is on the screen.
Wake up to the Good Morning Show, weekdays at 6 on WCTV. Art Myers, Jenny Prechter, and Rob Nucatola have your first look at local news and weather to start your day. Plus, sports, community events, and a whole lot more. The Good Morning Show, weekdays at 6 on WCTV.
Wake up to what's new on the early show, weekday mornings after the Good Morning Show at 6. Discover the difference right here on WCTV.
I'm Frank Reineke. Valdosta is home to Moody Air Force Base, Valdosta State University, and one of the area's top new attractions, Wild Adventures. This versatile city, originally called Troopville, moved to follow the railroad and was renamed in honor of Valdosta, the plantation home of former Governor George Troop. From Georgia's pine forest to Florida's Gulf Coast, we want to be your hometown source for news. Join us for Eyewitness News on WCTV.
For the best local sports, don't miss Lee Gordon and Eyewitness Sports.
Stop drugs. Save lives. Protect the environment in the Coast Guard.
The Coast Guard! Jobs that matter!
A get out and stay out slogan is educating people on fire safety. And Florida leaders hope to break down employment barriers for the disabled. Alcida Segui has these stories and more in tonight's Weekend Preview.
Week of October rings in National Disability Awareness Month. Congress put together the idea to help employment opportunities for individuals with disabilities. Through various programs, Florida increased the number of jobs available to disabled persons. On Monday, Fire Prevention Week kicks off. The goal is to inform the public on skills necessary to save lives. Firefighters will visit area schools telling kids to stop, drop, and roll. In addition to Fire Prevention Week, the Department of Financial Services and the State Fire Marshal's Office will deliver 500 smoke alarms. The alarms will be installed for free in homes in Gaston and Liberty County. The project kicks off an ongoing program that has led to 10,000 free smoke alarms throughout Florida. And finally, on Wednesday, October 8th, it's National Walk to School Day. The International Day raises awareness about the positive ways walking to school helps children and communities. The goal is to provide kids with safe walking behaviors and specific steps to create more walkable communities. I'm Alcides Segui, and that's your Weekend Preview.
Still to come, some area church members watch the sun go down and the money go up. We'll explain right after this. But first, your winning lotto numbers.
Today in Florida, 500,000 people discovered something that would change their lives. One little girl found a new voice. A father and son explored a new destination. And a couple found a new source for even greater freedom. My Blue Service. 24-hour online access that lets our members manage their health benefits like never before. Just one of many unique services making lives a little easier. From Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Florida. Learn more. Log on today.
Get what you need to know at WCTV6.com. You're just a click away from news, sports, and local information. Get a look at local radar, a pinpoint weather forecast, plus daily program schedules, polls, tasty recipes, and a whole lot more. Sign up for e-news and we'll send the top stories, weather alerts, and other WCTV features right to your computer free. It's information at your fingertips. Click on to WCTV6.com today.
As the sun went down over the skies of Tallahassee, one area church was busy raising money for some area kids. Close to 1,000 members from the First Baptist Primitive Church in Tallahassee filled Tom Brown Park playing games and eating plenty of good food. The church's pastor says this event was a great way for the church members to bond while raising money for a very good cause.
We're raising funds to help disadvantaged children go to our summer camps. And we have a good response to that every year, and we're anticipating being able to send a good number of kids next summer.
The activities included a free concert with names like Pam Laws, Jerry Evans, and Fred Lee. And it's a good thing they had such great music.
The church was graced with good weather.
Great weather, that's what I meant to say.
Yeah, good weather out there, certainly. And tomorrow not going to be too bad, although we're going to bring the rain chances back ever so slightly by the late afternoon. But only about a 20% chance. Mostly clear, comfortable when you wake up tomorrow morning. Around 60, there may be a little bit of thin, patchy fog around. But otherwise, it's going to be a nice, pretty morning out there for our Monday.
All right. Thanks so much, Matt. That's going to do it for us tonight. Thanks for staying up and making us your number one choice for news. Before we say goodnight, we want to take you out to California, where Nickelodeon's Let's Just Play campaign celebrated its one-year anniversary Saturday by bringing together kids and today's young stars for fun. Let's Just Play is part of Nickelodeon's grassroots efforts to encourage more active and healthy lifestyles for kids across America. Good night, everyone.
A power eye. And Sharp is the eye bank. Sharp gets the call, tries to go. No, Doherty, a great fake. Doherty still with the football.
Got a man
around,
open.
Got Paul Sharp in the end zone. Touchdown. Paul Sharp does it.
So stay in, cozy up, and call Live Links now.
Try Live Links free. 850-701-1111.
You ought to be in picture. You're
Have you met the director?
Watch Fox 49 weeknights from 7 to 8 for your chance to win tickets to Halloween Horror Nights at Universal's Islands of Adventure. And a shot at the grand prize.
Halloween Horror Nights 13, our most terrifying year yet. To save up to $22, log on to HalloweenHorrorNights.com.
UPN Monday, a daughter returns. Asian Julio Iglesias Jr.
Actually, I'm a lefty.
All new Eve.
Monday on UPN 2457.
Freshness that lasts all day for any shoe. Force the freshness in with new Kiwi Fresh Force.
While other mortgage companies are still filling out the paperwork, DieTech.com is busy processing your loan. Apply now for a low fixed rate mortgage. Call 1-800-71-FIXED. Your mortgage solution delivered.
Hidden Valley Ranch is coming to Chicago's Navy Pier. Asking folks, how should ranch dressing taste?
Creamy, thick, that's what it's supposed to taste like.
I can tell this is Hidden Valley because it's perfect.
I don't know of any other brands that can compare to this.
Hidden Valley Ranch dressing. We made it first, we made it right.
Really tastes good.
Hidden Valley Ranch, the way ranch is supposed to taste. A new Hidden Valley barbecue ranch. All ranch, a taste of barbecue.
Tonight at 8 p.m., watch Storm Stories.
An intense storm slams into...
You can see it here. We'll kind of draw it for you on the water vapor. The jet's coming in here. It's splitting. So our active southern branch down and through here is something we're going to be watching all week. But the ridge is just kind of sitting here over the plains tonight. And you can see the cloud motion, if you will, or the water vapor, if you will, almost spinning clockwise around that. And remember, under that ridge, you've got all this weight. And that weight is kind of sinking, so you get what we call compressional warming underneath that ridge, in addition to the southerly winds going around the backside of the street.
Kicks out on Route 66. Get your kicks out on Route 66. You'll be feeling real fine on Route 66.
Introducing Crest Whitening Expressions in kick and new flavors. Cinnamon Rush, Fresh Citrus Breeze, and Extreme Herbal Mint.
That really kicks it up a notch.
The whitening won't surprise you, but the taste will.
Workout. The 2-in-1 Tummy Time Gym.
99, 100. Hi.
Hi.
Play School. Plays cool.
PlaySchool.com.
Smart is having associates who are passionate about pets, who give helpful advice to keep your pet healthy for life, and who always provide gentle, loving care. At PetSmart, you'll always find the help you need to make your pet healthier and happier. Maybe that's why more pet parents shop here than any other specialty pet store. PetSmart.
Tomorrow.
Your son has become a problem.
Your little boy is developing some serious power.
Wyatt's powers become a threat.
Please help me.
Piper, if I could.
I cannot lose Wyatt, too.
Charmed. Tomorrow night at 10 on TNT.
His world was all business, but when he tried to make a little date...
A blind internet date?
He made...
I hope you like sham.
Fourth word, still can't rule out a passing storm or two on the sea breeze in South Florida, but better chance of rain across the South as we still have that active subtropical branch and an inverted trough giving you showers. Again, not a whole lot of severe weather, but definitely more wet weather. But much of the Southeast, not including Florida, has been dry as of late, so this is a welcome sight. That wraps up the Southeast. What's going on in the Northeast, Jennifer?
Well, as we look into the Northeast and looking ahead to tomorrow, we are going to be getting warmer, although it will be just a tad degrees, a few degrees below average, but yet again, it's going to be warmer than where you were today. Still, though, we're in store for a chilly night. In fact, a few locations are already down into the low 30s across extreme upstate New York, up into the Adirondacks, already around to 32 degrees. It's 51 in Boston, but as we look in a little bit closer, out into Nashua, up into Lexington, the temperatures are already down into the 30s. And in Norwood, you're at 35 with just a mile of visibility. So we are expecting some fog to develop across Boston, maybe even down to New York City, even into perhaps the D.C. area as we head into tomorrow with that high right over you. You will be enjoying beautiful.
What did you have for dinner?
Last night, I nuked half a soggy chicken burrito.
I zapped a veggie dog and four chewy buns.
I turned turkey into jerky.
I had a crispy crust pizza topped with mozzarella, Asiago, Parmesan, and Romano cheeses sprinkled with basil.
It was one of those New Lean Cuisine pizzas, right out of the microwave.
New crispy crust pizza from Lean Cuisine. It's not just lean, it's cuisine.
Introducing a new Fantastic. Infused with active oxygen, Fantastic Oxy Power. An all-purpose cleaner with the power to clean all kinds of surfaces, even carpet. Where Fantastic Oxy loosens and lifts away stains. Fantastic Oxy Power. That's Fantastic Power. SC Johnson, a family company.
I went to a plastic surgeon once. He had a bunch of little needles and a lot of big plans for me. That's when I realized, I don't need a new face. I need a new face cream.
Introducing a new Clinical. Our Derma3X technology boosts the production of collagen plus elastin and hydroproteins. No collagen injection works that way. So you don't just fix a wrinkle, you rebuild the look of your skin. Needles, pain, some women will try anything.
Me? I'm calling my Avon lady.
Get a new Clinical line of wrinkle corrector. The treatment that works like no collagen injection.
The newly redesigned 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix with 260 horsepower to help you get the most out of your ride. And OnStar stolen vehicle tracking to help you get your ride back. Fuel for the soul.
Tonight, Jay's all new and Katie Couric's back.
Oh, no, not again.
Oh, yes, she is, and everybody knows the reason why.
I'm hilarious.
Plus, Al Franken, Cirque du Soleil, and headlines.
I have a bowl of porridge every morning and fiddle with younger men in the afternoon.
Then on Conan, Carson Daly, NBC Tonight.
Are you a nurse?
NBC Thursday.
What are you shot me?
On an all-new ER.
What happens in the ER stays in the ER.
Abby! Ah! Crash card now!
A hero returns. A young doctor.
You said push it all.
Makes a deadly mistake. And for one nurse, the letter that will change her life.
Change is good, right?
Where's Lewis?
Abby!
It's never been better. All new ER, NBC Thursday.
News Channel 8 deputies find the body of a young boy in a Bay Area lake. But as is so often the case, missing in the story, a life jacket. The local chief of police, who is still asking, anybody seen my gun?
Do you know watermelon starts with W? You know there's ice in the Arctic.
Hey. With Casey the Kinderbot, kids discover the joy of learning.
The letter T.
Cheetah turtle.
There's over 40 skills to master.
Great job.
Plus additional cartridges, so the learning never ends. Good night.
Adios, amigos.
Casey the Kinderbot from Fisher Price.
And don't it feel good? Hey!
Flossing?
Ugh, it's a hassle.
Ew.
Ow.
Ew. Oh. NewReach Access Daily Flosser.
Whoa, a revolutionary flosser?
Hey, it looks like a toothbrush.
Cool. It's got a handle. Got a handle. I like this. It's easy. This will make me floss.
Introducing new Reach Access Daily Flosser. Flossing you can handle.
We're blonde.
We're brunette.
Our hair is straight
and curly.
And for millions of us.
And for millions of us, it's thinning.
Mostly because of heredity. Women's Rogaine can help.
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 It has the only FDA-approved ingredient proven to regrow hair in women. The sooner you start using Rogaine, the better Rogaine works. So take the first step at the first sign of thinning hair.
And know in your fight, you are not alone.
You're not alone. Rogaine works. The sooner, the better.
Once again, Yoplait invites you to join in our Save Lids to Save Lives program. For every pink lid you send in, we'll donate 10 cents to the Susan G. Komen Breast Cancer Foundation, up to $1.2 million. Together, we can lick breast cancer. Yoplait, it is so good.
Next Monday on an all-new Third Watch.
What is this?
The plague.
A contagious disease.
Please, help us.
One carrier has escaped.
Search every building.
9 million lives at risk.
Are we dying?
And time's running out.
Oh, my God.
All-new Third Watch, NBC next Monday.
later on The Tonight Show. The Today Show's Katie Couric stays up late to chat with Jay. Plus, the right wing's nemesis Al Franken and the magnifique Cirque du Soleil. Your local news is next.
Up next, was the death of this USF student in Iraq an accident? New information may have a fellow soldier facing charges. Plus, was former Bucks coach Tony Dungy cheered or jeered?
Applebee's Take Two is back.
One can have a dream, baby. Who can make that dream so? It takes two, baby. It takes two, baby. Make a dream come true.
Applebee's Take Two.
Just take two.
Choose two of your favorite entrees for one mouth-watering plate.
Eating good and